Simple Context Slider is easy and powerful plugin that will allow you to add a context form to your website that will be hidden behind a tab on the left or the right side of the screen. Basic settings include the activation of the slider, and you can decide on which type of pages you want it active. So you can use it only on home page or on search results or some other type of pages. All this can be controlled using filters so that through code you can control exactly on which pages you want or you don't want slider to appear. Basic settings include the location, so it is left or right. Then you need to select color style. There are 10 styles built in into the plugin by default, and you can set up effects like rounded shadows or compact so that form elements take less space than normal. And then you have some advanced elements and settings for slider form and slider tab. You can set up vertical position of the form and vertical position of the slider tab. You can set up size for a slider. There are several width and height options to consider. You can set up text that will appear on the slider tab, and a few other things also. There are external libraries you can use, Nice Scroll and Spin. Nice Scroll is useful when you have a lot of elements of the form active, or you are viewing a small screen. You are viewing the form on a small screen, like a mobile phone or something like that, and elements will take too much space, so that the scroll bars will appear. And using this Nice Scroll replacement, those scroll bars will look nicer. When you set up these basic things, you can save settings and you can try it out. And here it is. This is default contact form with some elements available here. Let's change the color style here. Enable some effects. Now you have a contact form that looks like this, much nicer than the previous one. As for the form fields, basic fields are name, email and message, and all these fields are marked as required. So you can disable that from here, and you have a list of additional fields. Each field has a required mark, so let's enable this one, but don't require this field, and enable website field. Now you have one more field, and both of these fields are not required for form submission. Advanced fields here include some special fields like subscribe, sent to selected email, and sent email copies to sender, with two extra fields that you can name any way you want. A subscribe field allow you to display subscribe to checkbox, and you can use one of the supported right now only MailChimp subscription services, so that the user can subscribe to your mailing list when submitting the form. Also, you can add additional field allowing you to set up extra emails that can receive contact form requests. So if you have more than one email, like this here, webmaster billing or support. You can add more of them here. Each one needs an email and a label. And you enable this field here, you will get additional drop down. Let's see how it looks like. And user can select where to send the message. As you can see, we have a scroll bar now, and it's using nice scroll so that more fields can be fitted into the form. Also, two checkboxes appear down there. One is to subscribe to a newsletter and to send a copy of this message to user for archive purposes or whatever. So, additional things you can set for fields are listed at the end, so you can limit the maximum length for some of the fields. If you want to change labels on fields, you can do it from this tab here, and there are many things you can set here, and you can change every bit of text that appears in the form. Contact disclaimer and all three messages listed here support HTML, so you can add the HTML into the field. Let's see how it looks like. We have an example here. Yeah, as you can see, we have bold and italic red values here. After you set up fields labels, you need to set up email. Here you can set up sending of the contact form submission, and you can switch between text and HTML content. At the end, you have templates for text and HTML. Both are using tags, and these tags will be replaced by actual values from the contact form. The list of all supported tags is here, and you have it also in documentation. Some tags can be used for subject for the email. You can select where to send the email, and you can attempt to change email sender so that it appears differently than it will normally be. Normal sender will be determined by WordPress, and you can override this here. There is no guarantee that this will work, because on some servers this might be an issue if you attempt to change sender to something that is not supported. But you can always test and see if it works for your server. Subscription is set here, and you have MailChimp settings. You need to add AIP key here, and once you do that, you will get a subscribers list and some additional settings you can set here. I am adding key right now, and based on the key you will get the list, the subscription lists, subscribers list you have on your MailChimp account. Select which one you want to use, and if users decide to subscribe to a list, they will be added to the list selected here. By default, if you can only send email to the subscribers list, or you can attempt to generate first and last name also from field in contact form. Plugin has several anti-spam options, and you can enable all of them if you want. Each of these options will attempt to minimize number of spam messages you will get from the form. Does that include the honeypot referrer so that contact forms without referrer will be removed? And for these two options, if spam is detected, IP that generated it will be added to the banned list of IPs. You can also enable bot detection and you can check against the list of banned IPs. Version 3.5 adds a styler. With styler you can create color styles to use and well, right now there are no styles here, but you have an example styles available with the plugin package, so you can install it from there. A file is available inside the package, and you have docs folder there and starter styler here. Select this file and only import custom styles from it. Now you have five additional styles here, and those styles will be immediately available from this drop down here. Let's see this one, for instance. So it works right away. Let's see how the styler works. You have several options here. You can copy and create a new style based on this one. You can edit this style. You can see the CSS for it in case you want to create your own style and modify it further than the plugin allows it. And you can delete any style from the list. Let's edit well, this one here. You have a preview here so that you can see exactly what changes you are making, and well, you can start from background. You can even make it transparent, or you can make it into any color you want. You can change border width. Well, basically any color you see here you can change to something else. Also, you can change fonts. There are plenty of default fonts available in the list. Here it is Georgia font, or we can switch to something else. And you can always make it larger. Or italic, or whatever else you want to do with it. Any element in the form can be changed. You can change name and code. Code is used to generate a selector for this style, and it is appended to this string here. Let's save it. And check it out now. And changes are immediately visible on the form. Let's see how the transparent form looks like. We have two examples here. Here it is. With the transparent forms, effects like a shadow don't look so good, so you should disable shadows. And the transparent form works just fine. Previously, we have seen export and import forms where you can export all styles and settings and import them back into the plugin. Let's now see how the email sending works. I have set up some settings here to use HTML emails to send and to change email sender. And let's see how it looks now. Let's change style to something more easier to look at. If you attempt to send it right away, you will see that some of the fields needs to be set. So fill in all the fields. Once you do all that, click send. And that's it. If something goes wrong during the message sending, you will get a message stating the problem. And in most cases, that can be server related if email cannot be sent with your current server settings. So there are many things you can accomplish using this list. Let's see some other combinations of fields. Let's disable this and include the country field, for instance. You can use extra fields. First, change the names for those fields to something like and enable this extra field one. And here it is here. You can also change position for both form and tab. Let's move it to the right. And let's put the tab a bit higher and form a bit higher. We can set bigger and a bigger tab here and change message here. You can make it smaller. So it's easy to change most of the things on the form.